What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can install a Teamspeak server on Linux. Now, why would you use Teamspeak over Discord, you're asking? Well, there's numerous reasons. Some of them are basically it's for competitive gaming because there's a lot less latency when you can pick your own server and it's more reliable. So it's going to be better for like if you're an esports team or something. And then if you're playing in a community with like a lot of users, then you can use things like Channel Commander to like split up the channels and then just have specific people talking in those channels. So I'm sure you've got your reasons for using it, but let's get into installing it. So to do this, we're going to be using a tool called Pterodactyl. Now, if you don't know what Pterodactyl is, basically it's a game server manager, which makes running games, bots, a whole bunch of stuff like Discord bots, Teamspeak bots, just so much easier. It's just a nice little web interface. If you don't have it on your server, I've got a quick install guide you can follow down below. It takes probably 5 to 10 minutes to get set up, but trust me, it's gonna make managing game servers just so much easier, and you can also give access to other people in your gaming community as well. So once you've installed Pterodactyl, you'll be at a screen like this here. Then all you need to do is click on settings in the top right hand corner. Then we need to first allocate ports. So let's click on nodes. Let's click on our node. So that will be your server. And then allocation. So then let's put in the IP address. And then we need to put the ports in. So let me just get the... Okay, so I'll leave a link to this repository in the description. Now, basically, it just gives you the ports that you need to allocate. So we're going to allocate these three ports to our server. So let's just copy them and then go back and paste them in here under ports. So you just want to get all three of them in. Of course, you can use whatever ports that you want to, but this just having it default means that all people need to do is type in your IP address or your domain name and they connect. They don't need to worry about any other long port on the end of it. So now we've got those allocated, we can click on servers and then click on create new. So we're going to click on server name. So we're going to give it a name. Let's go TS3. Server owner, type in your name, your username. And then under here, we're going to change the default allocation. So we're going to change that to the ports we just added. So the 9987 as the default allocation. And then additional allocation is going to be the other ports we added. So the 111 and then 333. So once we've done that, we can just scroll down. We can leave all of this the same except for memory and disk space. We're going to change this to 0, which basically gives them unlimited access to the disk space and memory. If you really know what you're doing, you can change these, but leaving them at 0 is fine. And then go to the nest here. We're going to click on voice servers and then Teamspeak 3 server. Scroll down a bit and it says here latest version, blah, blah, blah. You can leave all of that. Click create server. So now it's going to download the server and we can just click on Pterodactyl at the top left here and then click on TS3. Now, it's very important, it says right here, important, we need to copy this token into Teamspeak, so don't restart this server or anything yet. So let's click on here to copy our IP address, and then let's load up Teamspeak. Okay, so now we're in Teamspeak, we can literally just click connections at the top here, click connect, then let's just put in our IP address that we've just copied and the port, click connect. We're connected and then it says here enter the privilege key. Now this token right here is your privilege key, so this is gonna make you the super administrator of your Teamspeak. So we paste that in there, then click OK, and then privilege key successfully used, click OK, and then as you can see over here we are now the server admin, so we can go in and just create whatever channels we want to. Now we have full full control over the server. So it's that simple. If you ever need to like restart the server, which I recommend you do just to sort of get rid of this, because you don't want people getting your privilege key, just click like restart or stop. And that's it. As you can see, we reconnected straight away, and it's really that simple. So from here, you just set it up like a normal TeamSpeak server. You just add your own channels, change your server name to whatever it is you need to do. So I hope that helps you. I know it might seem simple for some people to install TeamSpeak on Pterodactyl, but with these ports, if you, speaking from experience, if you set the server up and then allocate the ports after you've set the server up, it can be a bit of a pain in the ass. So yeah, just doing it this way makes it so much easier. And plus, you know, if someone ever needs to manage this TeamSpeak server, you can just give them access to Pterodactyl, and they can log in here, they can restart the server, etc. So I hope that helps you out, guys. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, or come and join us on Discord. And that's it, guys. Just give me a like and subscribe, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.